Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Garima Jain from Rajasthan Technical University. Today we are going to talk on module Introduction to HRM, meaning, definition, scope, objectives and functions of human resource management from paper Human Resource Management. After completing this module, the students will be able to understand the meaning and definition of HRM. What is the scope of HRM? Describe the objectives of HRM. Understand the functions of HRM. Why name human resource management? Human refer to the skilled workforce in the organization. Resources refers to the limited availability or scarce. Management refers to maximize or proper utilization and make best use of limited and a scarce resource. The success of any organization depends upon how it manages its resources. While several resources are non-human resources such as land, capital and equipment, it is the human resource and its management which is at the heart of an organization's success. So, human resource refers to all the people who work in an organization called personnel. Human resource management refers to the organizational function which includes practices that help the organization to deal effectively with its people during the various phases of the employment cycle. HRM is management function concerned with hiring, motivating and maintaining people in an organization. It focuses on the people that are working in the organization. According to Lawrence Apley, working with, for and through people is the best way in which a manager accomplishes his job. Maintaining good human resources is a manager's responsibility. Providing human satisfaction from work output and relationship is a manager's obligation. In the words of Mr. N.R. Narayan Murthy, a famous personality, Chairman Emeritus Infosys, you must treat your employees with respect and dignity because in the most automated factory in the world, you need the power of human mind. That is what brings in innovation. If you want high quality minds to work for you, then you should must protect the respect and dignity. In the words of John F. Kennedy, our progress as a nation can be no swifter than our progress in education. The human mind is our fundamental resource. What do you mean by human resource management? Essentially, the human resource management is a management function that deals with recruiting, selecting, training, and developing human resource in an organization. It is concerned with the people dimension in management. It includes activities focusing on the effective use of human resources in an organization. It is concerned with the development of a highly motivated and smooth functioning workforce. It includes planning, acquiring, developing, utilizing and maintaining the human resources in the achievement of organization goals. According to Edwin B. Flippo, human resource management is the planning, organizing, directing and controlling of the procurement, development, compensation, integration, maintenance and separation of human resources to the end that individual, organizational and societal objectives are accomplished. The Indian Institute of Personnel Management defines HRM as the human resource management is a responsibility of those who manage people as well as being a description of the work of those who are employed as specialists. It is that part of management which is concerned with people at work and with their relationships within an enterprise. It applies not only टू इंडस्ट्री एंड कॉमर्स बट टू ऑल द फील्ड्स ऑफ एम्प्लॉयमेंट. अकॉर्डिंग टू टेड एंड मेटकाफ, ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजमेंट इज द प्लानिंग, सुपरविजन, डायरेक्शन एंड कोऑर्डिनेशन ऑफ दोज एक्टिविटीज इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विच कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू रियलाइजिंग द डेफिनेट पर्पस ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन विथ एन एनिमेटिंग स्पिरिट ऑफ कोऑपरेशन एंड विथ अ प्रॉपर रिगार्ड ऑफ वेलबींग ऑफ ऑल द मेम्बर्स ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. मिल्कोविच एंड बॉर्ड्यू व्यू एच आर एम एज अ सीरीज ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड डिसीजन्स दैट फॉर्म द एम्प्लॉयमेंट रिलेशनशिप, देयर क्वालिटी contributes to the ability of the organizations and the employees to achieve their objective. It is thus clear that human resource management is a specialized knowledge and practice concerned with the management of human resources in an organization. It constitutes a significant activity of the management. It attracts and selects capable men, organizes them in productive groups, develops their potential, gives them necessary motivation and maintains their high morale. Scope of HRM. The scope of HRM is indeed vast. All major activities in the working life of a worker from the time of his or her entry until he or she leaves come under the purview of HRM. Under the scope of HRM, we will study setting general and specific management policy for organizational relationships, establishing and maintaining a suitable organization for leadership and cooperation, collective bargaining, contract negotiation, contract administration, and grievance handling, staffing the organization, finding, getting, and holding prescribed types and number of workers, aiding in the self-development of employees at all levels, providing opportunities for personal development and growth, as well as for acquiring requisite skill and experience, developing and maintaining motivation for workers by providing incentives, reviewing and auditing manpower management in the organization, industrial relations research, carrying out studies designed to explain employee behavior and thereby effecting improvement in manpower management. The Indian Institute of Personnel Management has described the scope of HRM into the following aspects. First, it is the labor or the personal aspect. It is concerned with manpower planning, recruitment, selection, placement, induction, transfer, promotion, demotion, termination, training and development, layoff and retrenchment, wage and salary administration, remuneration, incentives and productivity. Second is the welfare aspect. This aspect is concerned with working conditions and amenities such as canteens, crèches, restrooms, lunchrooms, housing, transportation, medical help, health and safety, washing facilities, recreation and cultural facilities, etc. Next comes the industrial relations aspect. This is concerned with the company's relation with the employees. It includes union management relations, joint consultations, negotiating, collective bargaining, grievance handling, disciplinary actions and settlement of industrial disputes, etc. Objectives of HRM. The primary objective of HRM is to ensure the availability of a competent and willing workforce to an organization. That is, the main objective of HRM is to have a skilled and competent workforce, that is, right people at right place at right time in an organization so that the job and work is done in an efficient manner. The various objectives of HRM are as follows: societal objectives, organizational objectives, functional objectives, and personal objectives. Societal objectives. The societal objectives are socially and ethically responsible for the needs and challenges of the society. While doing so, they have to minimize the negative impact of such demands upon the organization. The failure of organizations to use their resources for society's benefit in ethical ways may lead to restrictions. For example, the society may limit human resource decisions to laws that enforce reservation in hiring and laws that address discrimination, safety, or other such areas of societal concern. Organizational objectives. The organizational objectives recognize the role of human resource management in bringing about organizational effectiveness. Human resource management is not an end in itself. It is only a means to assist the organization with its primary objectives. Simply stated, the human resource department exists to serve the rest of the organization. Functional objectives. Human resources are to be adjusted to suit the organization's demands. Functional objectives try to maintain the department's contribution at a level appropriate to the organization's needs. The department's level of service must be tailored to fit the organization it serves. Personal objectives. The personal objectives assist the employees in achieving their personal goals, as these goals enhance the individual's contribution to the organization. These personal objectives of employees must be met if they are to be maintained, retained, and motivated. Otherwise, employee performance and satisfaction may decline, giving rise to employee turnover. That is, the employees will leave the organization. Functions of HRM. Human resource management has an important role to play in equipping organizations to meet the challenges of an expanding and increasingly competitive sector. Increase in staff members, contractual diversification, and changes in demographic profile, which compel the HR managers to reconfigure the role and significance of human resource management. HR or personal department is established in most of the organizations under the charge of an executive known as human resource or personal management. This department plays an important role in the efficient management of human resources. Some of the major functions of HRM are as follows. They are divided into three categories, that is, managerial functions, operative functions, and advisory functions. Under the managerial functions, we will study about planning, organizing, directing, and controlling. Under the operative functions, we will have the study of employment, development, compensation, maintenance, motivation, personal records, industrial relation, and separation. And the last is the advisory functions. In this, we will study about the top management and the department heads. Now we'll study about the various functions of HRM. The first of all, we'll study about the managerial functions. And in that, the first is planning. To get things done through the subordinates, a manager must plan ahead. Planning is necessary to determine the goals of the organization and lay down policies and procedures to reach the goals. For a human resource manager, planning means the determination of personal programs that will contribute to the goals of the enterprise. That is, anticipating vacancies, planning job requirements, job descriptions, and determination of the sources of recruitment. The process of personal planning involves three essential steps. A supply and demand forecast for each job category is made. This step requires knowledge to both labor market conditions and the strategic posture and goals of the organization. Net shortage and excess of personnel by job category are projected for a specific time horizon. Plans are developed to eliminate the forecast shortages and excess of particular categories of human resources. Now we'll study about the next managerial function, that is organizing. Once the human resource manager has established objectives and developed plans and programs to reach them, he must design and develop organization structure to carry out the various operations. The organization structure basically includes the following. First is grouping of personal activity logically into functions or positions, assignment of different functions to different individuals, delegation of authority according to the tasks assigned and responsibilities involved, and the last is coordination of activities of the different individuals. Managerial function, directing. Now we'll study about the direction function of HRM. The direction function of the personal manager involves encouraging people to work willingly and effectively for the goals of the enterprise. In other words, the direction function is meant to guide and motivate the people to accomplish the personal programs. The personal manager can motivate the employees in an organization through career planning, salary administration, ensuring employee morale, developing cordial relationships, and provision of safety requirements and welfare of employees. The motivational function poses a great challenge for any manager. The personal manager must have the ability to identify the needs of the employees and the means and methods of satisfy those needs. Motivation is a continuous process as new needs and expectations emerge among the employees when old ones are satisfied. Now we'll study the last managerial function, that is controlling. Controlling is concerned with the regulation of activities in accordance with the plans, which in turn have been formulated on the basis of the objectives of the organization. Thus, controlling completes the cycle and leads back to planning. It involves the observation and comparison of results with the standards and correction of deviations that may occur. Controlling helps the personal manager to evaluate the control, the performance of the personal department in terms of various operative functions. It involves performance appraisal, critical examination of personal records and statistics, and personal audit. Now we shall study about the operative functions of HRM. The first operative function of the human resource of personal department is the employment of proper kind and number of persons necessary to achieve the objectives of the organization. This involves recruitment, selection, placement, training, development of the personals. Before these processes are performed, it is better to determine the manpower requirements both in terms of number and quality of the personnel. Recruitment and selection cover the sources of supply of labor and the devices designed to select the right type of people for various jobs. Induction and placement of personnel for their better performance also come under the employment or procurement function. Now we shall have a study of the next operative function, that is the development. Training and development of personnel is a follow-up of the employment function. It is a duty of management to train each employee effectively and to develop technical skills for the job for which he has been employed, and also to develop him for the higher jobs in the organization. Proper development of personnel is necessary to increase their skills in doing their jobs and in satisfying their growth need. For this purpose, the personnel departments will devise appropriate training programs. There are several on-the-job and off-the-job methods available for training purposes. A good training program should include a mixture of both types of methods. It is important to point out that personnel department arranges for training not only of new employees but also of old employees to update their knowledge in the use of latest techniques. Now we shall have a study of the next operative function, that is compensation. This function is concerned with the determination of adequate and equitable remuneration of the employees in the organization of their contribution to the organizational goals. The personnel can be compensated both in terms of monetary as well as non-monetary rewards. For this, the factors which must be borne in mind while fixing the remuneration of personnel are their basic needs, requirements of jobs, legal provisions regarding minimum wages, capacity of the organization to pay, wage level afforded by competitors, etc. For fixing the wage levels, the personnel department can make use of certain techniques like job evaluation and performance appraisal. Operative functions maintenance. It includes merely appointment and training of employees is not sufficient. For this, the employees must be provided with good working conditions so that they may like their work and workplace and maintain their efficiency. Working conditions certainly influence the motivation and morale of the employees. Working conditions include measures taken for health, safety, and comfort of the workforce. The personnel department also provides for various welfare services which relate to the physical and social well-being of the employees. These may include provision of cafeteria, restrooms, counseling, group insurance, education for children of the employees, recreation facilities, etc. Operative functions, motivation. Employees work in the organization for the satisfaction of their needs. To satisfy the employees, it is necessary to motivate them. The human resource manager helps the various departmental managers to design a system of financial and non-financial rewards to motivate the employees. For example, in sales department, the employees are motivated by the various incentives they are paid above their salary. Best Salesman of the Year award is given to a person who does his best in the department. Operative functions, personal records. The human resource or personal department maintains the records of the employees working in the enterprise. It keeps full records of their training, achievements, transfer, promotion, etc. It also preserves many other records relating to the behavior of personnels like absenteeism and labor turnover and the personal programs and policies of the organization. Now comes the industrial relations function. This is a very important function of HRM. The responsibility of maintaining good industrial relations is mainly discharged by the human resource manager. The human resource manager can help in collective bargaining, joint consultation, and settlement of disputes if the need arises. The human resource manager can do a great deal in maintaining industrial peace in the organization, as he is deeply associated with various committees on discipline, labor welfare, safety, grievance, etc. He helps in laying down the grievance procedure to redress the grievances of the employees. He also gives authentic information to the trade union leaders and conveys their views on various labor problems to the top management. Now the last operative function, that is the separation. Since the first function of human resource management is to procure the employees, it is logical that the last should be the separation and return of that person to society. Most people do not die on the job. The organization is responsible for meeting certain requirements of due process in separation as well as assuring that the returned person is in as good shape as possible. The personal manager has to ensure the release of retirement benefits to the retiring person in time. Now we shall study about the advisory functions. Top management. Human resource manager has specialized education and training in managing human resources. He is an expert in this area, and so he can give advice on matters relating to human resources of the organizations. He offers his advice to the top management. Personal manager advises the top management in formulation and evaluation of personal programs, policies, and procedures. He also gives advice for achieving and maintaining good human relations and high employee morale. Advisory functions of the departmental head. Now he advises the departmental heads also. Personal managers offers the advice to the heads of the various departments on matters such as manpower planning, job analysis and design, recruitment and selection, placement, training, performance appraisal and many more. So students, let's now summarize what we have learnt in this module. Human resource management is the management function that helps the managers to plan, recruit, select, train, develop, remunerate and maintain members for an organization. Maintaining good human resources is the manager's responsibility. Providing human satisfaction from work output and relationship is a manager's obligation. The scope of HRM is very large. All major activities in the working life of a worker, that is, from the time of his entry until he or she leaves the organization, comes under the purview of HRM. HRM has four objectives: societal, organizational, functional, and personal development. Then the HR managers perform three functions as we have studied in our course within the organizations, like managerial, operative, and advisory functions. Thank you.